Town car style with chrome Landau bars, right-hand drive Hooper custom coachwork rear-mounted spare wire wheels, and that traditional, instantly recognizable Rolls-Royce grille with the Flying Lady. Congratulations, Tom. Thomas Conduit. Hooper body, originally purchased by May Sinclair of London, a famous British sports writer. Pontiac, Michigan became part of Pontiac Motor later on and absorbed by General Motors. Two-passenger Oakland Roadster from 1910. Available at your dealer at that time for under $1,000. Pulitzer Award 1939. The colors are totally correct to the original build. What a sporty Bentley. One off. Congratulations.
Our next award is the Auto Owners Insurance Award, sponsored by Auto Owners Insurance.
At Vandenplaat Coachwork, as this is. Mostly original, a great survivor. Right-hand drive, British Elvis.
Our next award is the Swan Award. The International Sports
Cars in the world. This is a rare one. Only 39 of the 447 shipped to the U.S. had sunroofs, and that's what this car has. High performance.
911 Porsche.
High performance Porsche 911. Thank you, sir. Congratulations.
Our next award is the Best in Show for Boats. It is sponsored by Polk County Sports Marketing, and it's a 1949 Chris Craft Racing Runabout, owned by
Cab, model TT Ford truck.
1925.
Thank you.
He's all original. Even the horn works.
Next, we have the Best in Class Pre-War Production. Sponsored by National Parts Depot, we have a 1933 Ford Cabriolet owned by Peter Foley.
1933, the owners had it since 1953.
33 Ford Cabriolet.
Ford Cabriolet, a favorite pre-war flathead V8 floor ship, dual taillights, and a rear-mounted spare. Thank you, Rick. NPD sponsoring that trophy.
We have a special presentation for our Morgan Club Awards.
Just try to avoid those front-end collisions. A sport model with side exhausts and British Racing Green.
36 Morgan.
Our next Morgan
what
Club
Award.
That's wonderful. Our next Morgan Club
Metal over the wooden framework. And I believe there's a waiting list. This car has a three-position top. A very sporty British Morgan.
Our next Morgan is a 1981 Morgan Plus 8.
Racing red Morgan, left-hand drive built for the U.S. market. Rally wheels, louvered hood, hood strap for high-speed driving, dual rear-view mirrors. 1981 Morgan, just like brand new all the way from Cummins, Georgia. An Arrow 8 with an upgraded, what a great sports car from Morgan. built in the UK.
I hope you're taking that on the road rally tomorrow.
One of only 118 brought into the US. Congratulations.
81 Morgan.
Our next Morgan is a 2005 Morgan Roadster owned by Judy and Pat Buckley from Durham, North Carolina.
One of only 100 of this model. Congratulations, Judy and Pat Buckley from Durham, North Carolina.
2005 Morgan Roadster.
Hood straps, keep that hood down at high speed. Hand-built Morgan, just like they're making today.
Our next Morgan is the 2012 Morgan three-wheeler owned by Graham Addy from Augusta, Florida.
Return to the design from the 1930s.
Next up is our Best in Class American Elegance Award, sponsored by Carlisle Events. It's a 1968 Cadillac Eldorado owned by John Peters from Brandon, Florida.
A one-owner car. Second year for this Eldorado front-wheel drive design from Cadillac, the standard of the world. Front-wheel drive was designed, they thought it was going to get a V12 motor, but that program was canceled. That's why the hood's so long. Our XK150. 150 means it'll do 150 miles per hour. Left-hand drive, built for the U.S. market, a biscuit leather interior, chrome knockoff wheels, white walls. What a beauty. Double overhead camshaft, high-performance six-cylinder motor. Thank you very much, Lloyd.
Beautiful.
58 Jag.
This car, that is a national award winner in the AACA club. Many, many first place awards.
It's a 1967 Austin Healey 3000 BJB, owned by Peter Army from Stuart, Florida. It's beautiful.
Thank you. Great car. Austin Healey, high quality British sports car.
Our Swan Award for Best Post-War Production, 56 through 72, sponsored by Budweiser. It's a 1957 Chevrolet Bel Air, owned by Neil Wynn from Wesley Chapel, Florida.
A rotisserie, body off the frame restoration. That brand new body style, first year for the 283 V8. What a great year for Chevrolet. 57, one of the most collectible cars ever built by Chevrolet.
Our Swan Award for Post-War Production 45 through 55, sponsored by Maximize Digital, is a 1955 Chevrolet Nomad, owned by Paul Dimbath from Lakeland, Florida.
Our chief judge.
Right it is.
Paul, 55, first year for the V8 at Chevrolet at 265, and the first owner on that car paid $95 to get the Power Pack motor.
69 Plymouth
Roadrunner. There's some Mopar muscle, ladies and gentlemen. 383 Magnum. That's a two-door post car. Brilliant green. Steel wheels, small caps, red line tires, blacked out hood stripe, black interior. Mopar muscle at 383 Magnum, and they came even bigger engine than that one.
Car is a particular interest award.
You know,
Stacey, auto owners.
That might be the Pope in there. Is that the Pope?
I think it may be.
This may have been his car. That's Guy Wall.
1972 Mercedes-Benz 600 limousine, owned by Guy Lewis.
It's from Pinecrest, Florida, with his long wheelbase 600 Pullman limousine.
Sponsored. It's a 1957 BMW Isetta 300, owned by Doug and Adele Duba from Naples, Florida.
The Isetta was designed, developed by Rivolta in Italy, but this one built by BMW in Germany, and they had a nickname for it. It was called the Rolling Egg. And you see how you get in and out. You have to open the, there's only one door, and the steering wheel goes with it. This has a sunroof. What a beauty, a little Isetta.
Well, here we have
a mini car.
Well, we have another one rolling right on up. Best in Class of Small Cars, sponsored by Budweiser.
Stacey, this is the long wheelbase.
Sorry.
It's got a back seat.
This is the deluxe version. We have a 1958 BMW Isetta 600 owned by Larry and Christine Pope from Homosassa, Florida.
This model, the long wheelbase with a back seat, was only produced 2 years. Also built by BMW. What a great collector car they are today. absolutely a cult car. Rear engine, one front door. So if you have a front end crash, you may or may not be able to get out of that car. All right, what a winner.
Sponsored by Carlisle Events, it's a 1952 Avail Alf, owned by William Tribble.
You may not see another one for a long time.
52 Avail. Our next award is the Swan Award for American Elegance. It's sponsored by Polk County Sports Marketing. We have a 1972 Cadillac Coupe de Ville, owned by Stephen Will from Indiana, Florida.
1972 Cadillac, this is not a restoration. The owners that ran on the 2.5 mile banked oval that Packard built outside of Detroit, Michigan and Utica, at the time, the fastest speedway in the world. And Jesse Vincent wanted a high performance model. There were several built, one was supercharged, but I believe that only this one survives of the four or five that were made. From the Revs Institute, one of the most historic Packards you will ever see.
It's amazing.
Fenderless prototype Speedster.
For Polk Classics Group 1, sponsored by Maximize Digital, is a 1929 Packard Phaeton owned by Larry and Daryl Cole from Orlando, Florida.
A 640 Packard Phaeton, huge back seat. Beautifully restored, this car has all the amenities, luggage rack and luggage box on the back, dual side mounts, white walls, radiator grill guard, and the correct optional radiator ornament, wind wings, and those are wooden wheels, ladies and gentlemen, wooden spoke artillery wheels. Congratulations.
Our next award
is... Just ask the man that owns one.
Exactly.
They love Packard.
Our next best-in-class American Excitement Group 2 is a 1965 Chevrolet Corvette owned by Michael Hooker from Tampa, Florida.
High horsepower 327 motor, small block, 365 horsepower. That's as high as it got that year, 1965. Turbine-style wheels, three-prong knockoffs, blue inside and blue outside with a steering wheel, the Stingray, a Bill Mitchell favorite. Congratulations, America's sports car, Corvette.
Our next best-in-class international sports car, sponsored by Charter Communications, is a 1954 Lancia Aurelia GT, owned by Leo Scheigel from Miami, Florida.
This car's had a rotisserie restoration. It is left-hand drive, a rare Lancia B20 GT series, high performance, beautifully restored, 120 horsepower, Dedion rear suspension. It not only looks good, it sounds great. 350 V8 Camaro. What a great little pony car. They were called pony cars, but a lot of them had a lot of muscle. This one's red, black racing stripes, rally wheels, raised white letter tires. High performance Camaro 350 motor. Congratulations. Thank you, Rick. National Parts Depot sponsors that trophy, and they have a catalog of all the parts you might want for a Camaro to restore it.
Our next award is the Swan Award in Muscle Cars, sponsored by National Parts Depot. It's a 1970 Chevrolet Chevelle SS LS5, owned by Chip Watkins from Lakeland, Florida.
And what a rare muscle car. 1970, best year of all, perhaps, for muscle cars. LS5, that means a 454 big block. Biggest motor you could order that year in a Chevelle. Black, white racing stripes, cowl induction hood, and that big block 454 with a lot of horsepower. Had more horsepower than advertised. So try to get around some of the insurance requirements for high horsepower muscle cars in the 1970s. National Parts Depot sponsoring that trophy. Thank you, Rick. Big block Super Sport Chevelle. LS5,
Our next award is the Fields Motor Cars Award, sponsored by Fields Motor Cars. It's a 1971 Morgan V8 owned by Toby Bean from Lafayette, Louisiana.
Back to that traditional style of a Morgan. This one's left hand. They've got their own cheering section right over there. All right. That's a great looking Morgan. Beautiful wood trim inside. And a winner here at the Lake Mirror Classic.
Next up is our best in class post-war production 45 through 55, sponsored by Charter Communications.
Motorama cars. Cadillac introduced the Eldorado. Oldsmobile had the Fiesta. Chevrolet had a Corvette in 53. One of the Motorama cars, Eldorado.
Our next award is the Golden Anniversary Award, sponsored by Haycock Classic. We have a 1966 Pontiac GTO sports coupe, owned by Jim Smith from Ocala, Florida.
One of the first of America's muscle cars, Pontiac GTO, 1966. This is the sport coupe with red line tires, rally wheels, and it's got it all. 389 tri-power 4-speed. Great muscle car. Thank you, Jim, from the fabulous National Parts Depot collection in Ocala, Florida. Pontiac GTO, red line tires and rally wheels, and a 4-on-the-floor transmission.
Next up is our best-in-class full classics, Group 2, sponsored by Hemmings Motor News. We have a 1938 Cadillac V6 Imperial Sedan, owned by Martin Godby from Sarasota, Florida.
16 cylinders, one of the last of the 16s, 1938, fewer than 100 of these Imperial limousines made. Fabulous show quality, congratulations, Martin. Division window, jump seats, side mounts. 1938, the V16 production ended 2 years later in 1940. Only a handful were made. 16 cylinders. What a great car. Believed to have belonged to the governor of New York. 6-year restoration. Congratulations, Martin. Chauffeur driven. Leather up front, cloth interior in the back, division window and jump seats.
Coming through, watch out.
Next up, we have a Best Restoration Boat Award presented by Fields Auto Group. It was a 1959 Chris Craft owned by Stephen Burkhart.
Front wheel drive, the first front wheel drive built in America since the Cord of 1937, the pre-war Cord. From the Jim Schmidt collection in Ocala, front wheel drive, 425 high horsepower V8. What a statement, a very bold statement by Oldsmobile. Jim, is that car all original? All original, that's not a restoration. Oh my God, he's gonna wear it out. It's got 1,200 miles on it. 1,200 miles, all original. 1966 Toronado, that was the first year for the front wheel drive model at Oldsmobile.
Next up is our Swan Award for trucks, sponsored by Polk County Sports Marketing. We have a 1930 Ford Model A truck owned by Nevada Mora from Coral Gables, Florida.
And this is a very rare body style. This is the Roadster pickup. A true roadster with a pickup box. Many of them were worn out on the farms of the day. Most of the survivors became street rods. Here's one restored back to original configuration and beautifully done, a roadster pickup. That is the Model A, the model that succeeded the Model T at Ford Motor Company.
Next up is our best-in-class muscle car, sponsored by Auto Owners Insurance. We have a 1969 Chevrolet Chevelle SS, owned by Michael Merlo from Boca Raton, Florida.
High performance, big block 396, got that white interior, bucket seats, Magnum 500 wheels. You can hear the sound of that power. That's an AACA National First Place Senior Award-winning car. Antique Automobile Club of America, one of the best in the country. Four-speed on the floor, factory air. Congratulations, Michael. SS 396 Super Stock Muscle Car Convertible.
Next up is our Hemmings Motors News Award, sponsored by Hemmings Motor News. The 1966 Mercedes-Benz 250 SE Coupe, owned by Charlie Jenkins Jr. from Lakeland, Florida.
The first owner took delivery in Stuttgart, Germany, and brought the car back to the U.S. A one-owner car. One-owner car, 250 SE, Palomino leather interior, ivory steering wheel, an award winner. Congratulations, Charlie Jenkins Jr., our trophy sponsored by Hemmings Motor News, the Bible of the industry.
Next up is our Golden Anniversary Award, sponsored by Hemmings Motor News. We have a 1966 Ford Fairlane, owned by Chris and Kathleen Koch from Palm Coast, Florida.
And that is a GT, the high performance model with a 390 big block motor, four barrel, a GTA. That's an automatic, complete with hood vents, steel styled chrome wheels, white walls, immaculate condition. 335 horsepower in that mid-size Fairlane convertible. 1966, Chris and Kathleen Koch. Nice ride, Chris.
Next up, Best in Class Full Classics Group 1, sponsored by Charter Communications. We have a 1931 Auburn 8 98A Deluxe Phaeton, owned by Richard Lampert from Port Orange, Florida.
1931 Auburn four-door convertible sedan built in Auburn, Indiana. This one is the straight eight motor, a Lycoming straight eight, fold-out windshield, roll-up windows, side mounts, trunk in the back, Columbia two-speed rear end. And you can buy that car new, ladies and gentlemen, in Auburn, Indiana for $1,395. Auburn, built in Auburn, Indiana, the hometown of the classics.
Next up is our Art Eastman Award for Most Photogenic. It's a 1972 Ferrari Dino GT, owned by Leo Sligel from Miami Beach, Florida. Congratulations.
What could be better than a Ferrari, a red Ferrari? A Dino, red Ferrari with coachwork by Pininfarina, alloy wheels, wraparound rear window, immaculate condition, the world's sports car, Ferrari. A Dino, named after Ettore Ferrari's, Enzo Ferrari's son, Dino, Enzo Ferrari's son.
Next up is our Historic Race Car Award, sponsored by Polk County Sports Marketing. We have a 1968 Travis Sprint race car, owned by Paul Mondo from Fort Pierce, Florida.
What a racy car. Fully restored. Not many of these survived. This one's powered by a 390 small block Chevrolet with lots of horsepower. Four Venturi tubes sticking through the hood. Side exhaust, knockoff wheels, in its racing days. Chevrolet 390 small block motor.
Next up, we have a Swan Award for American Excitement Group 1, sponsored by Haycock Classic. It's a 1962 Chevrolet Corvette.
Little red Corvette with a red interior, hideaway top, 1962, the last year for the solid axle Corvette. Very, very collectible. This car has won everything in sight. NCRS, AACA, the Boca Raton Concours Lake Mirror Classic. It's a beauty. Thank you, Mel. Little red Corvette, the last year for the solid axle Roadster. In 1963, everything changed with Corvette.
Next up, Best in Class, American Excitement Group 1, sponsored by Hemings Motor News. It's a 1964 Chevrolet Impala owned by Evan Stone from Kissimmee, Florida.
And the owners have named it Annabelle. White, a white and turquoise interior, a super sport Impala, bucket seats, floor shift, wire wheel spinner hubcaps, dual rear fender antennas. Here's a full-size Chevrolet muscle car, a super sport Impala, 1964. 283 small block with 200 horsepower. What a beautiful Chevrolet, built like a rock. Annabelle, do you name your cars, Stacy?
Yes, anything actually you can repeat? I do. Right now I have, I call her Prissy.
Okay.
Because she's Prissy sometimes. Our next award. Oh, excuse me.
Here's a rare one.
It's a 1963 Florida Polytechnic Award for Design and Engineering. It's sponsored by Florida Polytechnic University. It's a 1953 Gregor Chaperon, owned by the Tampa Bay Auto Museum from Pinellas Park, Florida.
This car was purchased new at the New York Auto Show in 1953. Olivier, congratulations. Left-hand drive, purchased new by Ed Cole, who became president of General Motors. It was very technologically advanced. Gregory Chaperon.
Yes. Our next award is the Swan Award Pre-War Production, sponsored by Carlisle Events. It's a 1929 Peerless Model 681, owned by Brando Pistorius from Odessa, Florida.
With wooden spoke wheels, hydraulic brakes back in 1929, very, very rare automobile named Peerless. At one time, the three best cars in America were known as the three P's, Packard, Pierce Arrow, and Peerless, and you rarely see a Peerless. We've got one here today, a prize winner.
Next up, Best in Class for Trucks. Sponsored by Carlisle Events, we have a 1923 Ford Model TT, owned by Dan Shields from Upper Sandusky, Ohio.
All brand new wood. Boy, that's a lot of work. Restoring that Model TT truck. 23 Model T, a barn find, and it didn't look like that when he pulled it out of the barn. Totally restored. An open pickup design. Thank you, Bill Miller from Carlisle Productions, for sponsoring that trophy. A lot of work in that wood. Can you imagine? Wow. Everything works, including the horn.
Next up is our Best in Class post-war production, 56 through 62, sponsored by Fields Auto Group. It's a 1961 Pontiac Ventura, owned by Don McCullum from Ocala, Florida.
And this is the model that had the little top called the bubble top that was shared with Chevrolet. Beautiful two-tone interior and bucket seats. Those are eight lug wheels, special wheel design by Pontiac. Eight lug wheels, a Pontiac Ventura, less than $3,000 brand new for that car. Congratulations. Pontiac Ventura. Unfortunately, no more Pontiacs being built of any kind.
Next up is the Swan Award for Muscle Cars, sponsored by Haycock Classic. It's a 1968 Shelby Mustang GT500KR, owned by Tim Smiths from Osteen, Florida.
Well, this is one of the best, ladies and gentlemen, from the very fertile mind in the shops of Carroll Shelby. That's not a 350, that's a 500 GT, and it's the KR model. That's as big and as bad as they got, the king of the road, with a 428 Cobra Jet motor. 428 Cobra jet motor in that Shelby. Very few convertibles made, fewer than 100, and that is a beauty with the correct 10-spoke Shelby wheels.
Next up, we're going to present the car.
377 motor, big carburetors, 82-millimeter carburetors on that thing. That was a research vehicle pioneered by Zora Arkus Duntoff, known as the father of the Corvette, and what a job he did on that vehicle. Owned by Mike Yeager, nationally renowned Corvette collector.
Next up is our National Parts Depot Award, presented by Rick Smith. We have a 1957 Chevrolet pickup 3100, owned by Tim and Linda Bible from Orlando, Florida.
And what style you got in a Chevrolet back in 1957. 57, Tim and Linda Bible from Orlando, Florida. And all the options, chrome bumpers, chrome grille, dual chrome wind splits on the hood, side mounted spare, white walls, trim rings. What a beauty from 1957. First year for the 283 V8 that year, 1957. Trophy sponsored by National Parts Depot. Rick Schmidt presenting the trophy. That a short bed step side, what a beautiful pickup. Lots of eye appeal on that vehicle. Great to have a car like that here. Not many of them survived. 57.
Next up is the Chairman's Award, sponsored by Lake Mirror Classics, presented by Ford Haycock. We have a 1954 Packard convertible owned by Mark and Hillary Becker from Jacksonville, Florida.
Red and white interior, a stately, elegant steel gray Packard convertible. Last year, 1954, last year for the straight eight motor at Packard. This one's equipped with optional chrome wire wheels. Mark is the co-chairman of the Amelia Island Concours d'Elegance, and we're thrilled to have him here with his wife, Hillary. 54 Packard convertible, fewer than 1,000 of these were made. Just ask the man that owns one. One of the best cars in America, it's a Packard. Just ask the man that drives one. She let you drive it up here, Mark. I can't believe it.
Amazing. Congratulations.
Mark and Hillary Becker from Jacksonville, Florida.
Next up is our Cars of Particular Interest, sponsored by National Parts Depot. We have the 1963 General Motors Surf 2, owned by Richard Workman from Windermere, Florida.
This is the Surf 2 from 1964. We just had the Surf 1. This is the car that followed that, pioneered by Larry Shinoda, famed designer at GM. Designed the Stingray with Peter Brock. The Surf 2. Another special one-of-a-kind engineering vehicle from the Richard Workman collection. Tom Hill at the wheel. Tom, I hope you can get in there. Okay. Now that's an aluminum block ZL1 427 motor, the first one made. Engineering research vehicle from Chevrolet.
The next award is our Chairman's Award, sponsored by Ford Haycock. We have the 1960 Fiat Abarth 850, owned by Maria Lairdom from Winter Park, Florida.
Body by Zagato, one of famous Italian coachmakers, Zagato. There's room for two in there. A high-performance Fiat Abarth 850 coachwork by Zagato. It has an 850 V4 motor. Lots of horsepower with rally wheels and Ford Haycock to present the trophy. Ed and Maria Lairdom. This car was imported by Fiat of Canada and raced in 1960 and 1961. It became the Canadian champion in its class.
Next up is the Chairman's Award, sponsored by Lake Mirror Classic. Presented by Ford Haycock, is the 1927 Isotta Fraschini Tipo AAS, owned by Robert Jepson from Savannah, Georgia.
One of the most impressive, important, and valuable classic cars of the period. Isotta Fraschini. Now, this car has a great story. Usually, in the 20s, American cars were sent to Europe to have coachwork built in a special design. This chassis was made in Europe, and the chassis was sent to Detroit, where that body was built on special order by LeBaron. Isotta Fraschini chassis, LeBaron dual cowl fit and one-of-a-kind body, very, very expensive, around $10,000 in 1927. What a great survivor. We're certainly thrilled that that impressive car is with us today.
Next up is our Best in Show for the Lake Mirror Classic, presented by Ford Haycock. It's a 1942 Cadillac 6207 Sedanette, owned by Steve and Cheryl Cooley, Jr. from Homosassa, Florida.
1942 Sedanette Fastback Cadillac. Very few cars built by the American automobile industry in 1942, only about 90 days of production, and then the auto industry switched over to wartime production of war materiel. Lake Mirror Classic sponsored this. Ford and Stacy Haycock presenting the award to a 42 Cadillac Fastback Sedanette, Steve and Cheryl Cooley Jr. from Homosassa, Florida. Only 2,150 Cadillacs built prior to World War II. 1942 production with that indestructible, bulletproof, flathead Cadillac V8 motor that went on to power American tanks during the war effort. We have two groups for Best in Show, two Best in Show cars, ladies and gentlemen. This is one of them from Group 1. And here is our second one. One of our autobiography cars, left-hand drive, that's a Springfield chassis, an S-Code Rolls-Royce open front town car by Brewster. Open front town car by Brewster. The owner rode in the back. There was sliding division windows so he could give instructions to the chauffeur up front if the weather got bad. There is a panel that comes out of the roof to give the chauffeur driver a little bad weather protection. A Phantom II high performance six cylinder motor from Rolls-Royce. There they are, ladies and gentlemen, our two Best in Show cars. Our judges selected two wonderful automobiles and did a lot of work to get all these cars organized for our award ceremony. Mm-hmm.
Thank you.